overlooking Elliott Bay. This is Susan Spielberg.
Patio 5, your table's not available. Mizzle, you. Patio 5, your table's not available.
There's the kid. Kingdom, we're about 2 blocks from it. New buildings downtown. We thought it was pretty cool looking. Hi, bear.
Forward two rows up there, you'll find your jackets in that compartment up forward of your feet. Top. This is very important for obvious and not sitting down. Anyway, if you're standing and we stopped abruptly, it'd be real easy to toss you over a couple rows of seats, possibly even over the rail into that warm go for an unscheduled swim. Nor do we want you to sometimes. Anyway, all sorts of places. Queen Anne. It's one of the old things you manage. Another Budweiser boating school graduate over there. Well, oh boy, what's wrong with this picture, huh? Actually, you know, while we're here at a complete stop, if you'd like to stand for, Now this right here is a good example of this harsh winter we had here recently. The winter 96-97 was one of the worst we've seen here in Seattle in, I believe, 85 years. We did have record snowfall this year, record rainfall as well. So there are 250 cases where landslides have caused property damage in the area. This is the ground becomes so saturated in the first place. Somewhat understandable. Their second claim is that the city should have never, at least, these hillsides have been eroding for thousands and thousands of years, and if you build a home here, you're gonna have to expect this to happen. Any kind of settlement on the homes until the courts decide who is at fault. In this day and age, that's likely to drag on for years to come. The lady that owns the house is a bar plumber. Largest container ship in the world, but she's right up there with the best of them. She's about 950 feet long. She carries about 3,000 to 4,000 of these containers. Aboard, they fit real nice on semi-tractor trailers, on railroad cars. So from the time your goods and products are loaded inside them, you don't have to physically rehandle their contents until they reach their destination. Simply set the container here on the ship, and it's shipped out to wherever, whatever port city it's going to. Lowering these down into the holds, they work very exacting tolerances. They don't have a whole lot of clearance between that. From the size of these things, they actually travel in the open ocean at a pretty good clip. They have approximately 28 knots top speed in the open ocean. Mark will demonstrate here as run down the river how fast 28 knots is roughly. It's just over 30 miles an hour. It's going to be quite a bit to get a 75,000 ton ship with 50,000 ton cargo craft in that fast.
I've seen that.
Hello, guys. Navigation. She's got a top speed of about 38 knots. We've got a top speed of about 40 knots. So, don't have much on her, but a little bit. She's powered by a
Monolani.
Oh, it's the Monolani? Wow, that's a freak. On the last run, they said they came down and been watching that boat burn since 7 o'clock last night. Now, it's a good thing this doesn't happen very often, because a shipboard fire is one of the most difficult. This particular fire is burning in the cargo holds, so there's not very good, there's actually no accessibility. 17 right here is the USCG Mellon. It's a Hamilton-class high-endurance cutter, used primarily for law enforcement, drug interdiction, and fisheries enforcement.
Okay, this is Susan and the kid on the ferry. There she is. It's kind of a foggy day. Hey guys.
Yes.
Hi.
Hi.
Glad you're here.
Me too. And it's not raining.
It's foggy.
But it's not raining.
Ferry, that's where the cars go. Oh, there we go. head is down. This is Lopez Island in the San Juan Islands. Seals on Lopez Island. This is Friday Harbor.
Yeah, I don't like this right here. The photo just bugs me too.
From the San Juan Islands, this is the biggest island. stop. Lopez, that's where we were earlier this morning. Take us to Julie, our tour guide.